Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the introduction. So I'm currently a consultant at Open Source Integrators. We implement open source solutions to solve companies' problems. And the main areas, of course, ERPs, which where Odoo, the product I'm talking about, is quite a strong reference in the field. So this is my agenda for our talk. So I was going to make some introductions, but I think they are redundant right now. I'll just give you a short introduction to Odoo. So my talk does not intend to be about Odoo itself. It intends to be about the Odoo community, how are we organized, and how is our relationship with the product vendor, which has an open core business model. So I'll talk about the community challenges and how are we dealing with them, and what's our vision for the community and for this relationship with the software vendor. As for the introductions, I have written, I work with Odoo for about 8 years, and there was some very bad documentation at the beginning, and I wrote a few books about it, so I think they're popular among the community and help a lot of people. I'm also a board member at the Odoo Community Association. This is our website, and I did a very similar presentation to this one. Well, the audience is different. Last week, we had it was the yearly conference on Odoo, and the OCA organizes a code sprint, which is now not only a code sprint, it's a real event with talks and everything. So we call it OCA Days. So this is our group photo from the event from last week. It was in Belgium, and this is the presentation I did at the OCA Days. So it's basically the same presentation, but I'll obviously focus on different things here since the audience is different. So I don't know if any of you have heard of Odoo. Just raise your hand if anyone has heard about the product. So we have someone there. Okay. So what and who is Odoo? Because these are two different questions, okay? So Odoo, to start with, is a software product. It is an open source framework to develop business applications. So you can think about the usual user interface where you have forms and lists and you need to register document, the typical crude applications. So Odoo is very productive at designing this type of applications. And this is the type of application that usually runs a company's business processes. So if you want to record the master data on all transactions, this is the kind of application you do. So Odoo is very good at this. So it has a ready-to-use but very opinionated stack. So you can use only Postgres, SQL as a database. So you have all the stack components are pre-selected to you. So some people may not like this. Some people may prefer more options. But the other side of the coin is that it's very high productive. So you can build applications very quickly. You don't have to worry about a lot of the details that are built in, such as user management, access security, all that kind of stuff is built in. So you just need to design your application and start working. So that's my second preferred feature about Odoo. It's the high productivity on building applications. Another interesting aspect about Odoo, it's usually when you talk about open source software, a lot of people think about infrastructure software, so operating systems, web servers, things like that. And Odoo is really open source software that's running at the end user's workstations. So the end users are using this. So it's not just something that's hidden behind some user-facing software. Just to give you an overall idea, so how it looks like for those who don't know, this is the Enterprise Edition app menu, so where you have all the features. You can see that the breadth of features provided is is huge. So you have from payroll, accounting, inventory, sales, CRM. So there's a huge breadth of applications here. So this is a Kanban view where you can, this is an example for the CRM application where you can manage your lead pipeline. And this is an example for a regular form. In this case, this is a quotation. So this is just to give you a quick overview. That's, it's not my goal to talk a lot about the product. This is not a demo or something. It's just for you to have some idea. Now, I mentioned the second preferred feature. The first, the most, the feature I most value about Odoo, it's the ability, it's extensibility. Right, so Odoo has a new unique capability where you can add layers on, using layers, you can add features and features on top of that. And you do that creating separate modules that extend existing ones. So unlike many commercial products on the market, you don't need to touch the original code to extend it or change the behavior of it. So you create a separate module with its own source code that is able to extend and override or change the behavior of the original module. So, and this opens, this alone, adding the open source characteristics of the product, this opens a huge space for a community to develop additional features. And so you can build about anything with it, right? So you have some basic apps that are available out of the box, that usually is not enough, so you can add other apps or additional features or modify. And this is very important because every business is different. So most businesses don't have the same way to operate. And a lot of times it's their, those differences are their competitive advantage. So you don't want to operate the same as all like all your competitors. You want to keep your own competitive advantage, and you need to customize your software to be able to do that. So this is the example. So the OCA has built like a store where these modules, community made modules, are available. So this is an example of, so you have an idea of the kind of community models that are available. And all this code is available freely on GitHub, and people can go there and propose new features, fix bugs, report bugs. So the OCA really uses the open source values as a way to enable communication and enable all this community to work together. Okay, so this was the Odoo product. I talked a little bit about the Odoo community and how the way the accessibility of the Odoo product enables existence of this huge community. And then you have Odoo SA. So this is a company behind Odoo, which is a different thing. They have the same name, they are two different things, so we usually refer to it as Odoo SA. So it's a company that's driving the product, they created it. Initially under GPL license, but right now they have an open core model. So there's this community edition product and the enterprise edition product, and the enterprise code is not open source, it's closed. You can run the product as open source, so you have access to the source, but you can't disclose it, right? So technically, it's not does not fit the open source definition. So this bothers a lot of people. It has a downside and has an upside, which is the open core model allows Odoo to also fund the development of the product. So say they have 100 engineers in their office, R&D engineers in their office in Belgium. And this is possible because of the open core model. And the CEO repeatedly, and every year does that, did that again this year, states that 80% of the code will be in community edition and 20% of the code is enterprise edition because you need to have some differentiation. Another thing that is different from the totally community-driven projects, it's that the product is development, the roadmap is completely controlled by Odoo SA. So again, from the community side, this can frustrate some participants in the community because they don't agree on the direction of the model, they don't agree on the areas that are being redesigned, they may not even agree on some fundamental architecture choices. So the bottom of it is that there is a permanent, always some tension on some conflict there's between Odoo SA and the community around Odoo. So this is a bit about the having a GPL product that later on is no more fully open source. It has one side of the product is enterprise, and this is a concession to the venture capital, and this is something that goes against the pure principles of open source, and this bothers some people because it's a bit going to the dark side. So. For example, while 80% of the code is in open source, some core features like the accounting, the pure accounting features have been moved to enterprise. And another problem from the free open source point of view is that the migrations between versions are, so you, if you upgrade your product between one version to the next one, major version, you need the schema, data scheme is not the same. And you need to do a migration project. And the migration scripts are kept secret by the company. This is a way for them to force people to move it to enterprise because it's an enterprise service. So this all also bothers a lot of people. And to the point where there are a lot of people that went to look at the Odoo product say, no, this is not free open source software because it has these problems. You can't use it properly. You, while technically a lot of the, or the source code can be free to use, you don't have all the freedoms that are required to consider it to be a free and open source software. So this brings in the mission of the OCA and why the OCA exists and why the community organized around an association. So I want to go back a little bit and understand what was the main reason that made the OCA, the Odoo Community Association, come to life. So in the early days, so Odoo was running on Launchpad using the Bazaar source control system, and it was very hard to contribute at that time. And there was no centralized repository for information or reference, so code was scattered a bit everywhere on the internet. There were no common coding guidelines, so code done by different contributors would look very different. So there are a lot of problems in working together because of this. Also, there was no way to control quality. So you could find a few models on the web, download them, try them, and they wouldn't even install. They would have syntax errors. So that was not okay. Another problem is future duplications. So companies found that two or three companies were developing the same features. And that doesn't make sense because these are small companies from 10, 20 employees or perhaps less, and they're investing resources on creating features. Some of them are things that they just need to have in their market and are not value added for their customer. It's just something they must have to be able to start working with their customers. And this is a cost that is repeating this code is an unnecessary cost. There could be some collaboration that would cut down the cost for all these companies. So this was not working. While Odoo has this capability to have a community around it, in fact, it was not working and this collaboration was not being effective. Another thing about curious about our community, it has very different kinds of people. So on one hand, we have people that come from the open source side, either for universities or either they're just starting in IT areas using open source. And then they found Odoo, they found it useful to solve problems and sell solutions for their customers, and they started working with Odoo. And we have the opposite. We have people that come from the corporate world. They maybe were SAP or Oracle consultants. And at some time, they got tired of the business model and the way these products and these companies work. And they found Odoo. And they saw that Odoo could solve a lot of problems for their customers. It was a great product for them to use, and starting using it. So we have on the same room now, you have people where free and open source is a core value. It's something you don't question. That's your starting point. And you have in the same room other people that don't even understand why would you publish your code for free. They don't understand these concepts. So this is a challenge for our community association to get all these people communicating together to try to find, to give some value, good value proposition from all of them. So this is another challenge for our association. So how do we deal with this problem? How do we deal with this heterogeneity, all these quality problems? Something had to be done. And this was the first challenge, was really fixing the quality problem. So pragmatically, this was what was hurting more at that moment. And what we did that then for was we created, at this time, we were moving to GitHub. Now all the code has gone to GitHub. So we created the structure and organized the code in repositories, because there are so many different areas we work on. So we have lots of repositories. At this point, I think we have almost 200 repositories, each dedicated to an area, such as accounting, logistics, verticals, all kinds of business areas, management systems. And so having everyone knows where the code should be, okay? That was number one. Number two was to define common procedures to collaborate, the contribution workflows, and define clear standards and guidelines. We also provide, being an association, we ask people to sign a CLA to give them some legal protection, so to ensure that the code that comes into OCA stays into OCA under the same terms, same license, that original author does not change his mind and no longer wants to keep those licenses. And very important, we had a lot of people working on quality tools that did automated checks, confirming that the tests were correct, that the installation of the product did not break anything, some unit tests, integration tests. So we spent some time and invested all these contributors invested some time building all these features. And I must say that it was a success. And right now, the applications that have the OCA logo, because they were contributed through this process into these repositories, they are very well reputed in the community and are used by everyone. Probably almost every installations, a series installation of an Odoo product will have at least one OCA model in it. So this does not exhaust the usefulness for the Odoo Community Association, so we want to go further. And our vision is that we can have this community of hundreds, maybe thousands of individuals and small companies. And the vision is that we could operate together and work together the same way like the big consultancy firm could. So a big consultancy firm such as an Accenture or Capgemini or something like that is able to leverage resources in many of their offices to solve a difficult problem. So here in the community, I could have a company of mine that is going to Morocco and needs something specific there, and I go to the community and find maybe a solution to my problem, or if not, a good person with whom I can discuss that problem and arrive to a solution together with them. And maybe we can even be a subcontractor, you can do business together. So this is not only a community of developers creating something, it's also a community of companies and businesses doing work together and helping each other to achieve their goals. And open source, the open source thinking is something that underlines this and really enables this to happen. Because you used to share information with the other company, which are they are your frenemies, your competitors, and at the same time your friends. Another key idea about OCA, so there's some tension, and sometimes the community wants to go in different directions, and that's okay, as long as people want to work on a certain project, they're perfectly free to choose their projects. The only thing that the OCA tries to ensure is that we must keep, so Odoo gives us a lot. We don't want to fork it, we want to complement it, because it's a waste of resources to fork it. And really, even the community being huge, it's not possible to compare yourself to 100 engineers tightly coordinated and totally focused on developing a product. So it's very hard for a community, even with thousands of contributors, to match that. So we really need to be complementary and work together with Odoo every time we can. And of course, saying that, no, that's not the direction. We need to find an alternative to that in those rare occasions where we really, really disagree on how things are going. So one example is the upgrade, which is a problem. So the Odoo Community Association maintains a project called Open Upgrade, where we keep our own upgrade scripts. And the association funds that through our sponsors, funds that project, paying for all the migrations for our own instance. The association is managed using Odoo, and we pay for contributors to migrate our instance, and the scripts resulting from that are open source, of course. So, looking further, there's a nice vision of the future. This is a little personal. This is my idea of the potential that we have here. On one hand, we now feel that maybe we need, just like Ubuntu is Ubuntu is a distribution for Debian. It has Debian in its core, and then Ubuntu on top of it adds a lot of interesting features and usability. Maybe there's space to have an Odoo free software edition maintained by the OCA that builds up on the Odoo community edition, which is not so nice out of the box, a little bit on purpose, and do something that's much attractive and usable since when you install it and it has all these nice features out of the box. So, other thing that I find very interesting, so we have, I can say, thousands of modules, each one providing or a new app or a new feature. So I see that with such huge contributions, we could have like a business future library. So if your company has or a customer has a specific need, so if you look it up in this encyclopedia of business processes, you will probably find something that solves what you need or it's close to that. And this is growing every day. So this might be, has the potential to be the first business future library. I think nothing exists in the world and could be, imagine the potential and imagine the how many organizations could be able to use this as a free open source product. I'm talking about NGOs, associations, governments, municipalities, small companies. So the impact that we could have and enabling this could be have a huge impact on the world. So I say that we have, I think we have the potential to be here really a game changer in the world on software to manage organizations, not only companies. So I hope I got your attention. I hope you got interested on this and want to learn more. If that's the case, I invite you to contribute to the OCA or at least learn a little more about it. So you can find us at odoo-community.org, visit us. And so we're not only a technical community. 50% of the success for Odoo projects is from functional consultants. So people with a functional view are very welcome. So we have work for translators, functional people proposing futures, developers that want to solve bugs, implement futures, whatever. So there's space for everyone in our community, so you're invited to participate if you want. So that makes my presentation. Thank you. Here are my contacts in case you want to reach me after this. Okay. Thank you.